Welcome to Live at the Registry. My name is Lawrence McNaught. I'm a director of programming here at Kitchener's intimate Registry Theatre. Michael Kelly Cavan is one of our favourites, and we're delighted to have him back here. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Michael Kelly Cavan.
Well, he's up in the morning like a hungry bird, and he hears the things he's always heard. Wake up, dear, it's time for work. I'll make your tea and I'll iron your shirt. And he buttons his buttons and he ties his shoes, checks his watch as he reads his news. Another day he can't refuse, he marches off to pay his dues. Like clockwork, he's up with the sun. Like clockwork, he gets the job done. Like clockwork, he goes when the light is green. Like clockwork, he uses his hands. Like clockwork, he meets the demands. Like clockwork, he's wound up in a dream. Well, he takes his place on the factory floor like he's done so many times before, saying, what do I do this for? I just don't know. And with his friends it's all the same, an emptiness they dare not name. Players in a circle game, keepers of a dying flame. Like clockwork, he's up with the sun. Like clockwork, he gets the job done. Like clockwork, he goes when the light is green. Like clockwork, he uses his hands. Like clockwork, he meets the demands. Like clockwork, he's wound up in a up, dear, it's time for work. I'll make your tea and I'll iron your shirt. And he buttons his buttons and he ties his shoes, checks his watch as he reads his news. Another day he can't refuse, he marches up to pay his dues. Like clockwork, he's up with the sun. Like clockwork, he gets the job done. His hands like clockwork, he meets the demands. Like clockwork, he's wound up in a dream. Oh, 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 oh. brother-in-law's name is John. Guess you could say he's a man of few words. He likes to listen to us go on and on, talking about all the problems of the world. And when we've rambled along for a while, he'll lift his head up and say with a smile, in 100 years, what will it matter? In 100 years, we'll all be gone. We can live our lives for worse or for better. We'll be lucky to be a memory in somebody's history in 100 years. Sometimes when I'm out driving on the road and I pass by a place of less repose, I get to think of the souls lying there. Oh, lots of souls that nobody even knows. I get to wonder if it ever crossed their mind, an old weathered stone would be all they'd leave behind. 'Cause in 100 years, what will it matter? In 100 years, we'll all be gone. We can live our lives for worse or for better, but we'll be lucky to be a member in somebody's history in 100 years. Bad thing if we learn how to live every day like it matters right here and right now, and we don't let our time slip away. Do unto others as you have them do to you. Follow your heart to your own self, be true. In 100 years, what will it matter? In 100 years, we'll all be gone. We can live our lives for worse or for better, but right or wrong, short or long, we'll all be gone. In 100 years, what will it matter? In 100 years, we'll all be gone. Or for better, we'll be lucky to be a memory in somebody's history in 100 years. So here's a little song. A lot of the songs I'm going to sing tonight are songs that come from my own life experience, little family and friends and incidents. And this next one is a song about being an immigrant to Canada. Came here with my big family back in the 50s, and I understand when I, in my own little way, when all this talk about immigration is on now, that I sometimes forget that I'm an immigrant, and then I go, oh yeah, I'm an immigrant too. And the things you go through, you know. So this little song about, it's sort of a synopsis in 3 verses of us coming to Canada here. For reasons I may never know, my father chose to fly away to North America to see what he might find. He sent my mom a letter saying, pack the kids and come. So we left our house in Arvatown and sailed to our new home. We sailed aboard Ascania, a ship from Liverpool, and crossed the wide Atlantic to the port of Montreal. My mother took us on by train to settle in North Bay, a town in North Ontario with Ireland far away. Oh, I'm a child of immigrants, lost between two shores of this country I've been raised in and the one where I was born. My father worked his hardened hands to keep us all alive. My mother, she took the good and bad and stood right by his side. But the struggle took its toll on Dad, and he quietly passed away on a cold and windy winter's morn with Ireland far away. Oh, I'm a child of immigrants, lost between two shores of this country I've been raised in and the one where I was born. Songs my father sang when I was young, I get a feeling in my heart that wells up sweet and strong. And though I know I'll never live in dear old Ireland, oh, there's history running through my veins saying you're an Irish man. A child of immigrants, lost between two shores of this country I've been raised in and the one where I was born. Yes, I'm a child of immigrants, lost between two shores of this country I've been raised in and the one where I was born.
I don't remember any of that coming to Canada part, actually, but somebody told me, one of my older brothers and sisters, that at some point on the trip across on that ship, I fell down a big flight of steel stairs, head over heels. And sometimes I think that's the reason I became a musician. I'm not sure, but kind of a silly thing to do. So here's a little another song, actually, about growing up in North Bay, Ontario. And I love North Bay, so I've written a bunch of songs about in North Bay or going to North Bay. And this is a little song about the house that we lived in when we first came to Canada. We lived up on something called Thibault Hill in North Bay. If anybody knows North Bay, it's the highway going up, Highway 11 heads north, and just along that incline, we lived down a little country road there. So this is a song I wrote about my memories of that as a little kid.
I remember as a child growing up on Thibault Hill. that the yard went on forever, and they say it's that way still. Just a short walk down the road, there a two-room schoolhouse stood, with a grade in every row, and a playground in the wood. There's something there that draws me back across the many years, through the good times and the hard times, through the laughter and the tears. Those precious childhood memories make me think I'm back there still, in a backfield picking strawberries way up on Hill. Looking out our kitchen window, you could see the town below, and on Saturdays for groceries down with Mommy would go, and she didn't have much money, but we always had enough. We were fed on stew and soda bread and a heap of Mama's love. There's something there that draws me back across the many years, through the good times and the hard times, laughter and the tears. Those precious childhood memories make me think I'm back there still, in a backfield picking strawberries way up on Tibor Hill. Sometimes I take a drive there, down along that old dirt road, and I stop beside the empty lot where that big old red house stood, and I take a little walk, pick a strawberry or two, and I get a sweet reminder of the childhood that I knew. And the hard times, through the laughter and the tears, those precious childhood memories make me think I'm back there still, in a backfield picking strawberries way up on Tebow Hill. Those precious childhood memories make me think I'm back there still, in a backfield picking strawberries way up on Tebow Hill. Oh, 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 oh. Oh, my name it is Martin Haskins. This town is all that I've known. I've lived in this flat with my wife and the cat all these years together alone. And I gave of my life to the factory. Now my freedom is all that I own. But now they are saying that I should be staying down at the Highbury home. Down at the Highbury home. Well, I lost my dear Mary last winter. She never got seeing the spring. Oh, she took all the best of me with her. Sure, I'm only a half-living thing, but there's still enough living left in me. I'm freeborn right through to the bone. And I have no intention of spending my pension down at the Highbury home. Down at the Highbury home. I remember the meadows in springtime, summer sandcastles down by the sea. I remember the color of autumn and running through snow that was up to our knee. Well, my best old friend Billy went last year. He was just 80 years young. His children thought he would do well there, but he knew that the end had begun. And barely 2 months had gone by before my old friend he passed on. With no one to meet him, he gave up his freedom to die at the Highbury home. Damn that old Highbury home. I remember the meadows in springtime, summer sandcastles down by the sea. I remember the colors of autumn and running through snow that was up to our knee. Yesterday, said that I wasn't safe on my own, and there wasn't a lot I could do or say, for most of my strength it is gone. Well, I'm flat on my back in this white room, but I know very well where I'm going. When they come in the morning, my soul will be sailing far from this Highbury home. Damn this old Highbury home. La 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 la.
This little song I wrote about my mother. I think I wrote lots of songs about my mother too. But when I was a little kid and growing up on Table Hill, my mom used to sing every now and then. She had this wonderful little nightingale kind of voice, just a little high, flimsy note. And it was actually kind of beautiful to listen to her, sometimes when she'd be peeling potatoes or something like that. So I wrote a little song called Sing Mama Sing, which is about remembering that time with her.
Sing, Mama, sing. When it was time for me to go to sleep, she'd sing to the good Lord her little boy to keep. And in the morning I'd rise to her song, coming up from the kitchen as she put the breakfast on. Sing, Mama, sing like you used to before, while you rocked on the back porch and I swung on. Sing it up sweet like a bird in the spring. I just love to hear that sound. Won't you sing, Mama, sing? Sing, Mama. Mama passed on, she went to join that old heavenly throng. But late at night I swear I can hear that sweet, sweet voice of my old mama dear. May the circle be unbroken. Sing, oh, sing, Mama, sing, like you used to before, while you rocked on the back porch and I swung on the door. Sing it up sweet like a bird in the spring. I just love to hear that sound. Won't you sing, Mama, sing? I just love to hear that sound. Won't you sing?
Thank you.
was a late summer's day in 1995. Out on Highway 21, things were buzzing like a beehive. One side flak jackets, chopper in the sky. On the other side, a band of brothers in a bus, standing up for what's right. Years of anger, years of pain, born through generations, rising up again. In the land of the Shawnee, in the land of the Chippewa, where the ghost of Tecumseh lives, where Oshawnee and Signabike walked. Sacred land, sacred ground, where the bones of the ancient ones had been laid down. In their palace, drunk on their newfound power, losing all sense of common sense, looking for their finest hour. Hungry for action, someone said, empty the park. Miles away, a rifle's raised, and a shot rings out in the dark. Anthony O'Brien, brave you were to stand so tall in that darkest hour. We'll remember you, Anthony O'Brien, brave you were to stand so tall against the ones in power. Stood to right or wrong in the darkest hour. We'll remember you, Anthony O'Brien, brave you were to stand so tall against. Crying out, where is the justice for the life of Dudley George?
So here's a little song I wrote from years of experience of playing in legions. Most of my life I've played. I think I've been playing every weekend, I figured it at one time, for about 45 years. So I've played thousands and thousands and thousands of shows, and I've played a lot in legions, and mostly cover stuff, not doing this stuff here, but doing my own mixture of stuff for people to dance to and whatever. There was a lovely little thing about legions that I came to appreciate, which is that at legions, I don't know if maybe there's some legion members here, but when I first went to play at legions, I thought, oh my God, life is over. I'm playing at a legion. Sorry for any legion members, but I've come to just love them. I still play them, and one of the lovely things there's so, what I love about a legion is so unpretentious. It's just so real, and fantastic, wonderful people who are all about service, and it's just fantastic. And the lovely thing I like is that they like to dance, and so they dance, they dance that old style dancing. So sometimes, you know, depending on the legions I've been at, you might have 40 or 50 couples on the floor dancing that dance. I'm sure some of you here might have danced too, and you didn't go to Arthur Murray to learn it. I'm sure you learned it in the kitchen or in the barn or wherever. So it's a little song I call Two Step Life, which is about watching a couple dance at the Legion.
Watch them as they glided two as one around the floor. In a two-step they had danced, I'm sure, a thousand times before. Her yellow cotton dress floated like a carousel. Like skaters on a frozen pond, they moved around so well. With every song the band played, they were out there going round. Her silver hair was gleaming as the mirror ball shone down. I watched them in amazement, they never missed a beat. It seemed the story of their love was written in their feet. When the music stopped, I walked up to the table where they sat. I said, if you don't mind me asking, where'd you learn to dance like that? They smiled at one another, and the old man turned to me. It's really very simple, son, I follow where she leads. 'Cause it's a two-step life, perfect harmony. The first step I love her, and the second she loves me. And when we move around the floor, we hold each other tight. 'Cause love is all that matters in a two-step life. See, they treasured every dance in the smiles they wore. And I often think about them when my world is closing in. Him in love with her, and her in love with him. 'Cause it's a two-step life, perfect harmony. The first step I love her, and the second she loves me. And when we move around the floor, we hold each other tight. 'Cause love is all that matters in a two-step life. Yes, it's a two-step life, perfect harmony. The first step I love her, and the second she loves me. And when we move around the floor, we hold each other tight. love is all that matters in a two-step life. Yes, love is all that matters in a two-step life.
Okay, so this little song, a little sort of, God knows where sometimes songs come from. Most of the songs that I write, like I said, usually come from, well, I suppose this is from a life experience as well. But anyways, I went one time to Nashville, as a songwriter, and you can go down there for a week through SOCAN, which is the collection agency up here for songwriters, you know. And they have a little house down there you can stay at for a week, and you can walk around Nashville. And it was really a great experience. Met, you know, young writers, people who aren't known, just hordes of them. And you go to a little bar where there's an open mic, and they're from all over the country. Some of them are from Europe. And so, but anyways, when I was there, I took a little side trip down to Memphis and went to Graceland. And I don't know if you've ever been to Graceland, but, you know, I had this image of Graceland as being this mansion. It is a big house. I guess apparently it was a doctor's house before Elvis got it. But it's very small. It's very closed in. And the thing I remember most is that one of the rooms, I think it was the billiard room, it's got shag rug on the walls and the ceiling. Now you can imagine how claustrophobic a room like that would feel. I just thought, God, this poor guy had to live in here when he was... Anyways, so I came away with a different version of Elvis. An Elvis that maybe... Didn't want to be famous. Maybe he just wanted to be an ordinary guy. I don't know. That's probably not Elvis. I don't know. But it's just what struck me one day. So here's a little song I called "Get Me Out of Las Vegas."
Get me out of Las Vegas. Get me out of this jumpsuit. Steal me away in the trunk of your car. Don't let me out till we get so far. Nobody knows my name. Nobody knows my fame. Get me out of this Graceland. Get me out of this jungle room. Take me away in the middle of the night. We'll drive and we'll drive till you say it's all right. Tell me the coast is clear. Nobody knows me here. I don't wanna be your king. I don't wanna be your idol. I just want a simple thing, to be loved for who I am, not a king. Not an idol, just a man. Get me out of Las Vegas. Get me out of these blue suede shoes. Fly me away by the light of the moon to a southern choir and a gospel tune. Give me something that's real, something that I can feel. Get me out of this Graceland wasteland. Get me out of this Cadillac. Tell the colonel I've had enough. I've had my fill from this golden cup. Gone away and changed my name. Sold my face, cashed in my fame. I don't wanna be your king. I don't wanna be your idol. I just want a simple thing, to be loved for who I am. Not a king, not an idol, just a man. I don't wanna be your king. idol. I just want a simple thing to be loved for who I am. Not a king, not an idol, just a man. Get me out of Las Vegas. Get me out of this jumpsuit. Steal me away in the trunk of your car. Don't let me out till we get so far. Nobody knows my name. Nobody knows my fame. Get me out of Las Vegas.
So this is another song about, you want to figure out what city it's about? North Bay, yes it is. Actually, where this song came from, when I think about it, is that when I went back to Ireland and lived there for about a year and a half after high school. And when I came back to Canada, and I caught the bus north to North Bay, I think a couple of months later or something. And like we flew into Toronto, and then my mom was living here at that time. And but I remember catching the bus up north, and I remember when I came to where there were the rock cuts around Burke's Falls, I think it's around that area, it was such a, like I felt like I was arriving home, like geographically, you know? And I never realized, I never really thought, you know, that when you grow up, I was three when I came, how the landscape becomes such a part of who you are. So I just realized that heading up Highway 11 is like going home for me, and still is. So this is called Gateway to Heaven.
People say that paradise was the Garden of Eden, where the palm and the fig tree grew in the desert sand. But I grew up with the pine and birch, and I can't help believing there's a special place in the good Lord's heart for this fertile land. When I've been away for a while, head back up that highway, feel it building mile by mile till I'm back home again. And I'm heading north through the mighty shield and the granite walls on Highway 11. I don't know about you, but I get the feeling I'm passing through the gateway to heaven. Stars in a dark black sky, campfire on a lake, silver mist like ghosts arising in the morning when I wake. There's nowhere else that's quite as peaceful, there's nowhere else that fills my soul with such a joy and love for living as North Ontario. When I've been away for a while, head back up that highway, feel it building mile by mile till I'm back home again. And I'm heading north through the mighty shield and the granite walls on Highway 11. I don't know about you, but I get the feeling I'm passing through the gateway to heaven. highway. Feel it building mile by mile till I'm back home again. And I'm heading north through the mighty shield.
It was a little bit of a short notice thing, and it's so nice to see some, like I said, some familiar faces and some faces I haven't seen before. So this is a little song that I wrote. When did I write this? Oh, I remember when I wrote this. I was coming from a gig in, an open mic in Guelph, and I stopped at a Tim Hortons on the Highway 7 there. And there was this little screen up behind the donut counter. And I don't know why I was looking at the screen instead of the donuts, I'm not sure, but... And there was a little screen up behind it, and it showed a little one of those Timbit hockey kids, you know, with looking over his shoulder down a big rink, and it said, and under it, it said, "We've learned to love the game," and so I just took that as a I just took it as a title, and so on the way home I was writing this song, so this is a song I wrote, which I took as a sort of a metaphor for life and being a musician. I haven't always crossed the line ahead of all the rest. I haven't always had the strength to keep up with the best. I'm not someone that everyone will know my name, but through it all I've learned to love the game. I'm not the one who got to score the run that broke the tie. I'm not the one who had a year at an all-time high. My picture won't be mounted in a golden frame, but through it all I've learned to love the game. Win or lose, rise or fall, I always choose to catch the ball. Whatever life throws my way, I take my turn because I've learned to love the game. Through it all,
I've learned to love the game. Through it all, I've learned to love the game.